judgment is not even real, it's just subjective. Ostracizing and just bullying and everything, like the whole setting coming against me and stuff, I decided to pick up a book in my English class, and it was about vulnerability, and I read the whole thing, and it was really interesting to me, especially on the journey that I was on. I was like, yeah, vulnerability is important, and my upbringing, like many other people, you know, can relate. There was a thing with vulnerability where you weren't able to express yourself, you know? And you're not able to speak on, you know, certain things because you feel shame or you feel judgment. But I'm going to teach you that it's all about vulnerability and how to release those feelings. And that judgment is not even real, it's just subjective. But let's get into vulnerability. So vulnerability is one of the bravest things you can do as a being. So risky, but it comes with beautiful benefits. So vulnerability looks different and can look different for everyone, you know? But the basis of being vulnerable involves sharing personal stories, expressing emotions, expressing, you know, weaknesses, and overall admitting mistakes. This involves taking risks and stepping outside of your comfort zone for the betterment of you. Allowing yourself to take risks leads to personal growth, new experiences, and new opportunities. When you allow yourself to take risks, it helps you build confidence in yourself in a way where specifically you're like, okay, I'm going to take this risk, and if I do this, I trust myself and I'm confident that it will work in my favor. That's really what confidence is about, believing in yourself and having faith in your trust in yourself. Taking risks helps you overcome fears and limitations too. It's very rewarding for you in the end as well. And it may be scary, but the opposite of fear is really just change, you know? And change is always for the betterment of you. I'm always gonna remind you guys that. This leads to positive changes in your life when you allow yourself to take risks. Vulnerability is a big risk that you should definitely take with those who you feel comfortable with. Expression helps you to process, cope, and release difficult situations and experiences that you may have experienced. This overall helps, you know, clear up with your mental health and your mental, you know, it helps you release what's been being held onto, basically. This is very helpful for your emotional well-being. A lot of us put off our emotional well-being just for the sake of, you know, making others feel comfortable. You cannot do that because you won't be comfortable yourself, and that will begin to reflect on the outside of you externally, unfortunately. What we never want to do is suppress our emotions. Suppressing your emotions allows you to build up these, you know, feelings of discomfort in your whole emotional system. You know, your emotional stability is going to be broken down when you hold in things that don't make you really feel good. It causes stress, anxiety, and other negative emotions. Some ways of expression are journaling, you know, speaking with somebody you trust, somebody who's genuine, or even it could be a therapist, you know, a friend, a close one, a loved one. Engaging in creative activities, or even just self-talk. You can speak to yourself. Sorry for that, but you can speak to yourself and release these feelings on your own, you know? All you gotta do is allow yourself to. The first step is allowing vulnerability. You have to allow vulnerability for yourself first, and then for others. This allows you to create a safe and supportive environment for yourself to be vulnerable. allow this one open. You have to. Feel safe. Just in an environment where you feel heard. Where you feel able to be able to express yourself clearly. Your thoughts and your feelings, both. And like I said, you can find, you know, an outlet to express yourself by, you know, a trusted friend, a therapist. You can do, you know, with yourself. You can journal with yourself. You can speak to yourself. Whatever makes you feel safe and comfortable as you allow vulnerability. This also really looks like setting healthy boundaries and practicing self-compassion for your own. You have to give yourself compassion. And this looks like, okay, well, I know I just messed up with this situation. However, I give myself grace for that. I want some grace to this person. You know, and I know, you know, everything's going to be okay. And I know I have true intentions. And everything is working out in my favor. As I listen, that's what it looks like to give yourself compassion. Tell yourself, it's okay. It's okay to make mistakes. It's okay to, you know, backtrack. But the best part is being aware and coming back to yourself and then realizing what it is that you need to do and that what you want to do and what's going to make you feel better. Being honest with yourself and being empathetic with yourself is so important. Vulnerability is a process that takes time to build trust and open up. So first know that you trust yourself. That's the first step. You trust yourself. You know you do. So extend that trust to whoever it is that you want to express yourself to. Or, if it's just yourself, extend trust to yourself. There's a process. Be, you know, consistent and graceful with yourself always. Don't beat yourself up. So now that we've talked about vulnerability, now we have an gist of just what it is. Now we're going to talk about what restricts vulnerability. What restricts us from being vulnerable? There are actually many things that restrict vulnerability. There's fear, there's judgment, and then there's past traumas. We can conquer all of these. It can also, you know, be difficult for people who do not have a supportive community in order to open up to, you know? I have experienced that. So my choice was to trust myself and vulnerable with myself, and then I created the channel that really started to express to you guys, whoever's watching, whoever's supporting me. I began to be vulnerable with you guys, and that helped me to open myself up more and allow this vulnerability, especially with that book that opened my perspective completely. You know, restricting vulnerability comes with, you know, just blockages from the past. You know, old mindsets, old experiences, etc. Be careful. So, if you're watching this, I want you to know that it's completely understandable if you do feel as if, you know, it's hard for you to be vulnerable. I see exactly where you're coming from, and I've been there. So I get you. If you don't have a community that is willing to hear you, or support you, or even, you know, give you empathy or compassion, I'm here for you. That's why I have this channel. I'm here for you. I hear you. You're heard. You're understood. Because I get it. Some of us have been hurt in the past in ways where it's been difficult for us to overcome even in our daily lives, just certain events that have shaped us, you know, and the way that we think. So I can get you, okay? We can evolve over this and I can help you. So regardless of the things that you have been through, it is important to recognize these burdens of the past. In order to put, you know, a complete stop to it as it affects you, you know, on your subconscious on a daily basis, you know what I mean? You can put a stop to that. But first, recognize it. Don't run from it. It's really these barriers that are keeping you stagnant. These barriers that you have put up in your mind. And let's overcome them by seeking support. who are genuine, people who really want to hear you, people who are rooting for you. Seek support from those who are genuinely willing to help you, pure intention, for you and them, you know? This helps you to allow yourself to practice self-compassion, and then it's reflected right back to you. Are positive and with pure intentions, who want to help you, who want to heal you, and you can release these burdens and these, you know, experiences by speaking and releasing it through your, you know, vibrations, releasing it from your company. Now let's talk about judgment and releasing judgment. Judgment is a subjective statement. It's influenced based on personal bias and beliefs and experiences. You cannot be affected by judgment unless you allow yourself to be. Always remember that. If you control your reality, you control everything you go through. If you allow yourself to be subject to judgment, then it's going to, you know, affect you. It's subjective, not objective. It's somebody else's viewpoint, not yours. You know yourself. You trust yourself. You don't need any validation outside of you other than your own. It just shifts your whole perspective of yourself, you know what I mean? It throws you off when you seek validation from others. And when you listen to other people's, you know, judgments on you. But you know yourself, you know? While it can be hard to completely eliminate any judgment completely, it is important to act and recognize when it is happening, you know? And when you recognize when it's happening and how it's going down, how you're being judged, are able to completely take that energy and shift it into something different. That's called transmutation of energy. Everybody does it. Everybody can do it. You just shift it to something more positive in your mind. Whether you think it or you speak it, you're that powerful. When judgment does, you know, come about, shift it in your own favor. Shift that energy for it to work in your favor by giving yourself empathy or compassion. Allowing this energy to now shift, transmute, and to work in your favor. And say if somebody was, you know, judging my shirt, I could be like, oh, your shirt is too, you know, gray. I could be like, well, I did pick this shirt. I do like this shirt, and it looks good on me, and I like it, you know? So, and then that's me transmuting energy and shifting it to something more positive and beneficial for me. So that's just how you can do it. You just take something, look at it from your perspective, which is positive, and you go with that and you flow with that, and you're, you know, happier releasing that judgment and change it into something more positive. This is you now reducing the impact of judgment and now allowing yourself, you know, compassion and improving your relationships with others and yourself significantly, as you know yourself. And also remember this, giving yourself grace and others as well. You have to give yourself grace more often. And once you give yourself grace more often, you're able to give others grace. But if they come at you negative, you can just be like, I can feel you give them grace. You know, I'm gonna be patient. Give them grace. They may be going through something, everybody always is. So giving somebody grace and extending that to them is really easeful on yourself, and you have to give yourself a little bit of grace more often. There you're able to transmute negative thoughts into positive beliefs, shifting your external reality completely, and the qualities of yourself, the beliefs of yourself internally. It's also important to practice self-care, because self-care is allowing yourself to feel good. Always. Always practice self-care, guys. I love to be there. It's a gift to yourself. And your best of your life. I honor you. I love you. So I'm going to give you some self-care and self-love. Always be there. And also, remember to seek support when you need it. Always. I love you guys. I hope this helped your vulnerability. You are such a powerful, strong being. And, you know, hold true to that. I love you. Bye.